Although their form in Serie A wasn't great, in the Champions League they were much more competitive. They progressed as group winners and met Glasgow Celtics. Celtics put up a good fight, but Milan went on to win in extra time thanks to a solitary goal from Kaká. In the quarterfinals, Milan rushed off Bayern Munich in the Allianz Arena with a 4-2 win on aggregate to book themselves into the semi-final against the United side in dazzling form.
Pippo Inzaghi! 2-0!
Manchester United had come off a 7-1 win against Italian club AS Roma. The first leg, played at Old Trafford, started out badly for Milan, as Manchester United scored early with a goal from Cristiano Ronaldo. But Milan answered back thanks to a brace from Kaká, taking a 2-1 lead at halftime. Manchester United would ultimately prove victorious thanks to two second-half goals from striker Wayne Rooney. But back at the San Siro, Milan was nothing short of perfection. Kaká gave Milan the lead. Seedorf doubled it at the stroke of halftime. Alberto Gilardino came on as a substitute and finished the game off to put Milan in the final. Again, against Liverpool. The 2005 final left a scar on the club, and only one thing on the minds of the Rossoneri: revenge. There was no better place to get it, as Athens was also the venue when AC Milan won their second European Cup. Liverpool started brightly, creating chances and controlling the tempo of the game. But right before the halftime whistle, Milan went in front.
It's Pirlo, it's in! Filippo Inzaghi! Goes racing to the Milan fans, it was his final touch!
With the final 2 years ago still fresh in the minds of the Milan players, they knew that one goal wouldn't be enough. Liverpool put the Milan backline under constant pressure, Gerrard having a great chance to bring the game level again. Yet again, it was Milan who went 2-0.
He slipped it in, it's Pippo Inzaghi, he's round the keeper, and he has won the European Cup for Milan!
The moment was Inzaghi's. Milan were European champions. It was to be the last major honour for Milan, as they have now gone 3 years without a trophy. With the retirement of Maldini and the departure of Kaká, Milan needed to rebuild the squad to compete for major honours. But the future looks bright. The purchases of Zlatan Ibrahimovic and Robinho has given the team an attacking edge the team had been lacking ever since the departure of Kaká. They also have Alexandre Pater, at just 21 years of age, is already touted to be the future's best player in the world.
Pato, Ibrahimovic, Rubinho, and now with Cassano, future, at least the attacking future is bright.
It's no surprise that AC Milan right now is number one with the best Brazilian players on this team.
But Milan is a team, a family, and needs more than skilled individuals to be successful. But if history is anything to go by, then Milan will be back among the elites of club football again.